Hi, everyone. I'm going to be doing something a little bit different for the newsletter this month and doing a 5-minute feature on antisense oligonucleotides, or ASOs. What exactly are they, and why have we been hearing so much about them? So I'm going to share slides for just a few minutes. And in order to unravel this, we need to get to a fundamental principle of biology, which is that DNA is the blueprint for RNA, and RNA helps make proteins. Most of us are familiar with DNA, which contains the many genes that make us who we are. And RNA helps turn the DNA blueprint into proteins, which are the action-oriented molecules that carry out many functions in our cells. They fold and they help with cell structure, transport, and biological reactions. So why does this matter? PMS is a genetic disorder, which means the underlying cause is an alteration to the DNA. If the DNA blueprint is disrupted, that means RNA can be disrupted and proteins can be disrupted. For instance, in PMS, most people have an alteration to DNA for the SHANK3 gene, either caused by a deletion or a variant. And that means there won't be as much functional SHANK3 RNA and SHANK3 protein. SHANK3 protein is important for brain development and nerve cell communication and function. Drugs designed to treat PMS can intervene at any of these three stages and beyond more broadly. For example, they can attempt to address the DNA with techniques such as gene therapy or gene editing. They could also target later stages of dysfunction by delivering proteins needed for brain cells to function better. Antisense oligonucleotides, or ASOs, are usually designed to target the intermediate step, RNA. ASOs are synthetic structures that can bind to RNA and modify it. Antisense refers to the complementary sequence, and oligonucleotide is a short stretch of building blocks of genetic material. ASOs can modify the RNA in a number of ways. They can alter the processing of the RNA, or they can alter how much protein is made from the RNA, either increasing it or decreasing it. So these ASOs can be developed to be rather specific to a disorder by targeting an RNA of interest in that disorder. In this case, we're looking at SHANK3. We've been hearing more about ASOs recently because two announcements have come out that ASOs are being developed that could be used to treat PMS in the future. One came from a pharmaceutical company called PYC Therapeutics, who have added an ASO for PMS to their pipeline. PMSF has been in conversations with PYC to help make this a reality and help them get all the supports that they need. Separately, researchers in Germany with expertise in SHANK3 and autism research recently released a publication identifying two ASOs with relevance to PMS, and one of these team members was recently on the PMSF Scientific Advisory Committee. Both of these approaches have found a way to increase SHANK3 protein by modifying SHANK3 RNA with ASOs. The hope is that by increasing the amount of functional SHANK3 protein, this can start to correct some of the issues underlying PMS. With any therapeutic, there are challenges to implementation. Therapeutics targeting RNA or DNA can usually only target a small amount of material, such as one gene or the RNA for that gene. This is rather than multiple genes, which can be lost in a larger deletion in PMS. And it also doesn't account for those people in PMS who do not have SHANK3 involved. Delivery of the therapeutic is also a challenge because it needs to get to the tissue most affected, such as the brain. This can be tricky because it can require troubleshooting with packaging of the drug or the dosage and could require a localized injection. With all therapeutics, it's unknown at what age they will be most effective. So why is it promising? They're thought of as a disease-modifying approach, meaning they aim to address the underlying reason for the disorder by targeting the DNA-RNA protein pathway in a way that is specific to PMS. This does not mean that therapies which don't target DNA or RNA itself won't be successful, and at PMSF, we are invested in every avenue of drug development. It's important to remember that development of any therapeutic can take years. Most of the experimental drugs for PMS, including ASOs, are currently in what's called the preclinical phase. In this phase, a therapeutic has been developed and it has shown promise and is now being tested in models of the disorder, such as cell or animal models. If the therapeutic can improve outcomes in these models, the drug developer can apply to the FDA or another regulatory body to test it in clinical trials. The process to get to clinical trials and then once in clinical trials takes years. And you can learn more about this on the PMSF YouTube channel, where we have done a couple of videos on clinical trials. So all of these studies, articles, videos mentioned in this recording can be found in the full-length blog post, which you can find just by scanning this QR code with your phone. Thank you so much.